Ah, every day is a good day for some science. So put on your goggles. I have mine. Get ready. We are about to blow your mind. Jason Lindsay, also known as Mr. Science with Hooked on Science, joins us now. Thanks for being here, my friend. Always a pleasure
for having
me.
Yeah.
This is exciting. We've been talking about this for all week, so
yeah.
Let her rip. What do you have?
Well, we have a fan here. It's pretty fun. First and foremost, kids, before doing any science, have an adult around, wear the appropriate safety gear, don't eat your science experiment, pick your nose often, right? Okay,
right.
So, well, maybe not the last part,
yeah,
but a fan.
Don't take the grade off your parents.
Exactly.
Son.
I made this unsafe, but for this experiment, we've got to do that. I've taped some TP on there.
Right.
It's amazing what you can do with a fan and some toilet paper. So let me have you stand over here and kind of hold this like that.
Right.
And I'm going to pull this a little bit and hold it up high.
Okay.
And then what's going to happen is we're going to create something I like to call the TP Twister. Let it hold up high and look at that.
Oh!
Isn't that pretty cool?
That is very cool.
You can let it spin around forever. And
that's a nice demonstration for someone to understand what a vortex is.
You're
exactly
right.
We talk about rising air inside a tornado and things like that.
You're exactly right. It is that season for severe weather. We're spinning it. The fan likes to pull everything toward the outside, but it's also pushing out, and you'll notice how it jumps around all over the place.
And you can make little perturbations probably along
you
the
could.
Way as well and
yeah.
disturb it in certain
well,
ways.
Let's try that. Put our hand in there and you'll notice it doesn't
you'll
do too much
up
but
the
rip toilet the toilet paper.
That's what you're going to do.
But you got to also understand that a tornado is a little more powerful than toilet paper.
And don't get that close to a tornado.
Exactly.
All right, what's next?
So a balloon right here. How do you pop a balloon, and I already have one inflated, with an orange?
I don't know.
Oranges are sharp, right?
No, they're dull.
They're dull?
They're round and dull.
So how do I pop this with that? Do you have a hypothesis?
No, I don't have. Well, I throw it at
you could throw it, yeah.
If I get it just right.
It could, or you go ahead and hold this,
okay.
And I'll take the orange. You don't mind balloons popping,
no.
do you? I'm going to peel the orange.
Yes.
And in the peeling, there's something called an orange oil.
Okay.
That oil is super sharp and will actually pop the balloon. Matter is made up of small pieces. Balloons are matter. And this will take apart those smaller pieces. Okay, let's
Did
set this on the floor so everybody can get a really good view. Okay, we're going to squeeze the oil on it just like that. And there
and
we
it's
go.
It's going to eat through it.
Can you believe that?
That's crazy.
Oranges are sharp.
I mean, I would say oranges are acidic, but I didn't
know
that it had that much dynamic to it.
Isn't that pretty amazing?
That's pretty amazing science right
okay.
there.
Okay, a big, giant, 6-foot-long bag you put dirty diapers in.
Oh, okay.
You hold that. We're going to stretch it out.
Have there been dirty diapers in it?
There have been no dirty diapers. Right. How many breaths of air do you think it might take someone to blow this up?
To blow it up?
Yeah, six rulers. What do you think?
Six rulers?
Yeah. 500.
Yeah, I would think. Yeah.
Now, I see your co-anchors over there. Are they full of hot air?
They are full of hot air.
Can we have
air.
One of them come over
Matthew,
and blow it up?
Matthew, get over here. Yeah,
what?
Matthew,
what do you need?
He says you're full of
Hold
hot
on.
Air, dude.
Oh.
Wait, do you, need, you really need me?
Yes.
Okay. How many breaths of air is it going to take you to inflate a 6-foot-long diaper genie bag?
Well, based on my past experiences, I would say,
thank you.
Quite a few.
Quite a few. Let's try.
Can I make a suggestion?
Like that?
Do not inhale from the diaper.
Yeah, is this used? Is this fresh?
It is brand new.
Okay, well,
well a few hundred kids. No, I'm joking. I'm joking.
Join the club.
So let's do 5 breaths. I think you can do it in 5. That's 1, 2, 3. Are you okay? 4. Last but not least, 5. Okay. Do you need an ambulance or anything?
I'll be fine.
So there's that. 5, 10. We'll go to 15. Okay. Watch this. You hold that. Let's stretch it out all the way. Go back just a little bit more. 1 breath.
Wow, that's so
Isn't
cool,
that amazing?
Though. Look at that. And look at how much, look at the pressure.
Yeah, that's great.
That's awesome. That's
Bernoulli's principle. This guy knows about that. Faster Bernoulli's principle.
Bernoulli effect.
Fast flow of air, lower pressure, able to blow it up.
Draws
Isn't
air
that
in
amazing?
With it.
Okay, let's twist it really fast, and then we're going to see if we can. There we go.
Nice
right
work.
There.
Oh, nice. Going to catch it, too. Nicely
yeah.
done.
Yeah.
Very
Here's
quickly.
Our last one. We got
last
time for
one.
This. Oh, come on. We need your help one more time,
Matt, 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 Matt.
One more time. Hurry, hurry. Okay, I need you to hold this side for me.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And you hold this side right here.
We'll have to do this on Facebook. I'm
okay,
sorry.
Okay, no, you're good, you're good.
I'm sorry. We're going to do this. We'll get it on Facebook. You can find it there as we post this on KMOV.com/greatday as well. Following the show.
That was a lot of science. Thank you very much, you three.